Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today we're going to discuss in depth the photo mode within the camera option of your iPhone for taking photos. Let's go. Let's talk about the photo mode, which you probably use 90% of the time, and let's discuss some of the options and kind of go in depth of all the different modes for the timer, for the flash exposure, the autofocus, all of that. So let's go ahead and dive right in. If I touch the camera app, usually it will go to the photo mode depending on where you last left it or the settings that you currently have configured. But right now I'm just on the photo mode here and I'm just kind of hanging out in my studio. The first couple things I want you to note are the options across the top. So on the phone, I have in the top left, the little lightning bolt, which represents the flash. So right now it's set to on, and if I touch that little option, it's gonna put a line through it, meaning that the flash is turned off. If I touch it again, I turn it back on. The next one right next to it is called night mode, and this works best when it's really kind of dark outside, and it's almost like combining a long exposure where it keeps the shutter open to let more light in to produce a better photograph when it's dark outside. The middle choice going onwards is a little toggle menu that actually pulls up a screen right on the bottom there. So if I touch this again, notice I see slow-mo, I see video, photo, portrait. If I touch at the top, it now turns to different options that I can have more control over. And then in the top right, I have live mode, which I can toggle on and off. Now, these quick access buttons in the top left and the top right really are actually in the bottom here. So when I touch that option in the top center, that little carrot, it actually gives me the choices for the flash, the night mode, the live mode, the ratio, exposure, a timer, and filters. So let's go ahead and start from the beginning. If I touch in the bottom left, I can go to the lightning bolt, which actually gives me my flash options. Usually the flash is set to auto, where the phone is going to determine what it thinks is best in order to use a flash or not to use a flash. And sometimes you're in that position where you really don't want the flash on. Well, just touching that top left option, sometimes, depending on how you move your camera around, it will actually turn flash back on. So if you touch flash off and keep it that way instead of having it on auto, that might be helpful. So I'm going to touch flash off and I'm going to touch the lightning bolt again so I can see the other choices. The next option here is night mode. And night mode, if I slide this to the right, it brings me to auto. Or if I keep on sliding to the right, it brings me to 1 second. Now, the reason I only see 1 second is because I have these nice bright lights on me. And maybe I'll turn those off at the very end and I'll show you kind of what that means. Actually, let's just do it now. Let me turn this off. There we go. And let's turn this other one off here. All right. So now it's kind of dark in here. Hold on. Let's turn off this other light. Turn off this light. You've seen everything. Okay. Notice it got really dark, and notice the in the top left it shows a 3S. So what that means is on here it's gonna do 2 seconds maximum. And if I even close the shade here, let's bring this down a little bit. It's gonna get darker. Come back around this way. We go sideways. And so now if I take a picture with this, notice how it kind of goes through. It has those little crosshairs. So it wants you to line up those crosshairs and so it can capture all of the light. And let's go even further darker. And we'll turn this guy off. There we go. Now we're in like 4 seconds, 6 seconds. All right, so this is a good example. So notice on my camera, I have, and then we'll go back to vertical here. So it's changing from 5 seconds to 6 seconds. If I touch up there and go to night mode, it's doing max. If I keep it at auto, it's gonna do what it thinks is best. Now, the night mode is designed where you don't want to actually move as much as move around because your photo could come out blurry. So it's best to have it with a tripod. So I'm going to touch the shutter button and it's going to count down, tells me to hold still, and then it takes that photograph. And if we look at it, it's going to kind of supposed to do really, really well in the darkness, which it actually does a decent job. It's just a matter of making it so you're not moving around so much. And notice if I do move too much, that's where it gives me this little crosshair. And if the goal is to hold that crosshair right in the middle. So let's do that again. I'm going to take a picture and purposely move it. So it wants me to match up the little plus sign there, and then it takes the photo. So that is night mode. It's designed for pictures in the dark when you don't have a lot of lights. All right, let's turn these lights back on and move on to the next option. It is live photo. Now, live photo is a lot of fun because live photo allows you to, it's like taking video in front of the photo and after the photo, and you can do these really fun effects with live photos. Live photos right now, I'm gonna turn it on. Now, I'm gonna wave here. What I'm gonna do, see, I have my screen over there. So if I take a live photo and I wave, now if I touch on the top left, I have this live photo. If I press and hold, it actually records it almost like a video. So you capture some of the audio before and some of the audio afterwards. Now, what's really cool about this is if we go into our photos and we scroll down and go to, where is it? Live photos, there we go, 3,000. I have 3,000 of them. Ah, live photos is fun. Let's pull up some of the photos. Actually, let me give you a good example. We were in Lanesboro. Let's just do this photo here. All right, so now Lanesboro is actually the Children's Museum. Yes, the Children's Museum, because, you know, not a child. But anyway, so here's a live photo, and notice in the top left, just like a previous video with portrait mode, I have live showing in the top left to represent that this is a live photo. And if I touch and hold on that photo with my thumb, it actually plays it for me. If I swipe up on that video, it now gives me choices for different effects for this live video. So I actually have the live video itself, the raw natural one. If I touch on loop, it will go through and now it does an automatic loop for me. So it will loop and it will loop. And if I swipe back up, I can do bounce effect. Kind of like the boomerang effect a little bit. So it bounces back and forth. And then the next one is long exposure, which just looks terrible because it's not ideal for this particular photograph. I'm gonna keep it on bounce and then it will actually stay that way for me. So that's pretty much what live photo does. It allows you to have some action to your still image. I'm gonna go to my favorites though, because I know I have some other live photos that are good examples. Okay, so here's another one, live photo. This is a bounce one. This is in Lanesboro, the one I was talking about. So I had a pile of leaves and I'm just kind of bouncing and I threw them up in the air. If we look at the original photograph of the live photo, again, it's all non-destructive, so I can always go back and see what the original looked like. So here's the photo. And so it takes like that 5-10 seconds worth of video, and there it is. And if I swipe up, I can loop it, and now it just looks like I have a never-ending amount of photos or leaves coming out of my arms. Or I can do the bounce, and then it kind of goes back, and they come back into my arms. And then again, long exposure, not the most ideal for this because I'm moving and that's kind of not what it's intended for. However, a long exposure is good for something like this photograph, where here, let's turn this sideways, it makes the water nice and smooth because the water's always moving, but everything else is nice and still. So if I go back to the original photograph here, notice this is the original. Keep on going back and forth. I don't know why I do that. This is the original where it's capturing the water. It doesn't look smooth. It doesn't, it's there. But if I swipe up on this and I can look at the loop, I can look at the bounce, or I can look at the long exposure, and now it's got that nice soft flow of the water. And again, this is, you prop up your phone against a rock, or if you have a tripod, anything like that, keep it super still and you'll have nice, nice results for these options. So let's go back to the camera, and that is live photo. Now the next choice that we have is our ratio. And so this either makes it into a square photograph, a 4:3 ratio, or a 16:9 ratio for widescreen. Usually majority of the time you'll want to keep it at 4:3, just because if you want to print, you know, 4:6 photograph, probably is a better ratio than 16:9, because you're going to, that's more of a widescreen format, so you're going to end up chopping things off. Most people keep it at the 4:3, unless you want to shoot square for, you know, I don't even know, Instagram, or maybe your profile picture. I don't know, but you have that choice to change that. The next option is actually new, and I noticed it, when iOS 14, I think 14.1 came out. So if you haven't updated your phone, which actually iOS 14.2 just came out yesterday, so update your device if you haven't already, but I now have a control for the exposure. So I can actually drag this all the way down or all the way up, and it's gonna make the overall photograph lighter or darker for me, which is kind of nice. So you have that choice. The next option is, and actually, let me take a step back. You know, often when you're moving your phone around, notice how the light and everything changes, because it's automatically adjusting the exposure and the focus. So I always tell people that whenever they're trying to take a photograph, always touch first on what you're trying to focus on, because that's gonna focus the lens on that subject. But also notice that little sun to the right. I can actually drag on the screen up and down to increase the brightness or the darkness, the exposure also. So naturally here, if I touch in the ceiling here, notice how it makes everything else really, really bright. If I touch here on the light, everything else goes dark, because I'm changing focus and the exposure on the light versus the ceiling. This works really, really well if you're outside, which it's now kind of dark outside, but if you're out in the bright daylight and if you hold your phone up and you touch the sky, it's gonna focus and auto exposure to the sky, so you'll be nice and blue, but then everything else is gonna be darker. Whereas if you touch someplace on, like the trees or a house or something like that, it's gonna blow out the sky, which makes it really, really bright, and then everything else is gonna be in focus and correct exposure. So just kind of play with those. You know, touch where you wanna go and then drag up and down so it looks best to suit what you're looking for, and then you can go from there. The other option too is you can lock your auto exposure and focus. Notice as I move my screen around, that yellow box will often pop up. Let's see if we can make it do it again. Probably won't, because I want it to do, but that's okay. Anytime you touch on the screen, it does it. But if I touch and hold on the screen, it now produces an auto exposure, auto focus lock. So now no matter where I go, it's automatically locking that exposure and that focus on where I touched on the screen at that point in time. So now notice if I come down here, it's not gonna change. It's still focused in on that light. And then I can take the picture and go on about my way. I can also then come back down to the exposure here and further adjust everything if I wanted to. So lots of little controls for the exposure and the focus. The next thing down here at the bottom, and let's take off autofocus just by touching it. The next thing down at the bottom is the timer. So the timer is the one that looks kind of like a little clock. If I touch this, I have a timer for either 3 seconds or 10 seconds. And let's do 3 seconds here. And if I do that, it actually counts down 3, 2, 1, and then it takes the photograph. We'll do 10 seconds here, and it counts down on the screen here, 10, 9, and it actually shows the little light there so that you have a reference so you can count 3, 2, 1, and then it takes the photograph. And so now you have that timer. Also, if you have an Apple Watch, you can control it with your watch too, which is really nice. I don't have one, but I used to. But when I did, it was nice. Now the last and final option, let's go ahead and turn that off. We'll put exposure back to where it was. And the last option that we have under the photo mode itself is the filters. And the filters are just the fun kind of, you know, Instagram kind of, you know, filters for your phone. That's really all that they are. They just change the photograph. And so I can say, dramatic warm, perfect. So let's do it up close to the microphone. Dramatic warm, it looks so cool. And then I can come back to the photograph. Notice it's a live photo. I can touch and hold. I can hear my audio with it. I can touch edit on there. And I can also always go back and change that dramatic and those effects and filters also. So I'm gonna touch cancel, discard those changes, and I'm left with that live photo with that filter applied. So photo, that's pretty much the whole gist of it. It's one mode that we use probably the most, but there's a lot of different choices, a lot of different settings within that one app also. Notice also, now that the filter is turned on, I forgot to turn it off, it shows that the three little color circles in the top right. So I'm going to touch the top center, I'm going to slide to the right, I'm going to go to my filter and move it back to the original, that way it's not there anymore. So that is the photo option. Oh, one last nice trick for you. You know, you're out and about and you want to quickly take video. So if you touch and hold, if you touch quickly on the white circle shutter button and slide to the right, it automatically goes into video mode, and now I'm taking video. And even while you're taking video, I can touch the white circle, and it will take pictures while taking video, which is really cool. The other option, if I touch and hold on that white shutter button circle, oh, we should call it. Maybe it is called the shutter button. I don't know. I would imagine it is. But if I touch and quickly slide to the left, notice on the screen, now it's taking a burst photo. And a burst photo essentially means it's taking rapid shots. It's a whole bunch of photographs. So if you want to capture, you know, your kid running and jumping through the air and kind of freeze that moment in time of them jumping, I just took that burst mode. And when I go to those photos, it now says burst in the top left. It took 35 photos just now. And I can even touch select in the bottom center, and I can actually see all of those individual photographs there. Now to take a look at this a little bit better, let's actually go to the photos. Wow, we're really going in depth here, I tell you what. Let's go into photos, let's go to bursts, and I have all of these burst photos. So here's a good one. Here's Lisa doing a cartwheel. So we're out on California. So a burst photo automatically takes all of these pictures that I want to use. And if I touch maybe, or I tap the photo here, and now I can select that photograph and I can say done, and it's gonna say, hey, do you wanna keep only this one as a favorite or keep everything? I'm gonna say keep everything. So burst photo, really cool. But again, the way that you do that, just touch and hold, slide really fast after you touch it, or really just slide to the left. If you touch too long, then it's gonna take a picture, and that way you have that burst photo. That is the photo mode on your iPhone. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, go ahead, hit that subscribe, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.